Alright guys, we're back. Okay, so we're stranded on this island here on the Forest Haven still. I just need to get back to the King of Red Lions here so then we can just do what we want to do. I should have probably just started the video off on the King of Red Lions instead of starting it off here. I need to catch on Beetleship before I drown. Well, actually you could probably just ride Beetleship back. I'm just going to try and swim for it. I don't know how far it is going to be to get... I think that's the entrance. Here it is. Okay, it's the docking area. Almost there. Almost there. I'm about to drown, though. Crap. Link, don't drown on me now. Okay, so, I need to go south, which is in this direction. No, in this direction. Yes, right, okay, we need to point the wind in this direction. Well, I had it pointing southeast to get to the treasure chest that we picked up in the last video. You know what, I didn't check my treasure chest yet, which I can do right now, before we set sail. So I just want to double check and see which island this is. I mean, for all I know, this could be the Forest Haven's treasure chest. No, it's not, it's Eastern. No, it's not. It's not Eastern Fairy Island. That's, or is it Eastern Fairy Island? Yeah, it actually might be. Or is it? Yeah, that's Eastern Fairy Island. Okay. At least we cleared that up. Right. So, we could get that at some point. I'm not gonna go get it now, because I just can't be bothered. We're gonna go straight to, Boating Island and get that one done, and then, wait, actually, do we have one? Yeah, we do. I'm pretty sure we do. Got one on Boating Island. Flight plan to, yeah, Boating Island. I do remember seeing it. I wasn't having like any hallucinogenic visions and thinking that there was one there, but no, there is. We need to get the proper gear out. So let's get a grapple hook ready. I don't think I really need to make any cuts in between getting to these islands because they're very relatively close to where we are, so it's not like I'm traveling halfway across the world map to get to these locations. Alright, we need to go a little bit southwest here, I think. Yeah, southwest. And, yeah, the column of light you can actually see from quite a great distance. You don't need to be, like, right up close to see it. So you can always tell if there's a treasure chart on that island just by sailing around. We might actually just be right over it. No, we're not. Okay, never mind then. Let's just sail a little bit backwards here. Is it on this side? Because I might be on the wrong... Yeah, I was on the wrong side, dude. what do we have here? We have a sea chart. Sea Hearts chart. That's what it is. I think this actually tells you where a lot of the heart pieces are on the ocean, like on the Great Sea. Let's have a look and see what it shows us. Yeah, I think it basically just shows you the locations of the treasure chests that have, that give locations to heart pieces, I'm pretty sure. But considering you're going to be getting all the treasure charts in the game anyway, that treasure chart is pretty useless. I mean, I don't know where all the heart pieces are in this game. Like I say, I've never 100%ed this game before in terms of collecting all collectibles. I've never... I'm not even sure if I got all 4 bottles in this game. I know I didn't get the magic armor, so that's the first time I ever got the magic armor. Playthrough too. So, yeah, aside from, like, you know, minor collectibles like that, I've never gotten all the heart pieces. I've come close, though. I think I've got all of them filled in, apart from 2. Like, I didn't get 2 hearts on my life meter. It's too dangerous to go any further. Go back. What the heck? Did we go too far out? Did we just sail right past the island that we wanted to go to? We're still... Oh, right, okay, I'm sailing at the bottom. Why am I sailing towards the bottom? I have no idea. Oh, yeah, because I pointed the frickin' wind south, didn't I? We're meant to be going east. South. Crap. Yeah, I was wondering, because we didn't go out of bounds. Well, we did, but my initial reaction wasn't, expecting to have gone out of bounds, but... Well, that's going to make this sail even longer now, because we're so far south that we have to sail more eastward now than what we would have had to have done if we sailed directly east from Boeing Isle. Blech. Yeah, sucks. Yeah, I just wasn't thinking. God, look at all those pea hats. They're freaking everywhere, dude. It's like a whole swarm of them, a whole nation, a whole colony of pea hats. Man, they must be breeding like there's no tomorrow. Alright, what island is it then? There's like one out in the distance over there. Isn't that an island, or the heck is that? Do you see that, or am I just blind? There's like stuff in the distance. Hang on, let me just get my telescope out here. What the hell is that? Or am I just... Oh, it's a submarine. It's a submarine! Yeah, we could do that. We could do that. But first of all, I'm gonna do what I originally came here for, and that is to get this treasure chart. Well, I guess there's more content than for this video. We can do a submarine, and then, I don't know, that might actually take up most of the video doing that. Hopefully it's not a really intense one that's, like, gonna really badly screw me over, but we got plenty of heart containers now. And we have the bow and arrow, which helps a lot. Also, if we struggle for health, we could technically use the magic armor, but the only problem is with using the magic armor, it consumes magic, just as you would expect. Well, it's not as bad as the magic armor in Twilight Princess, where it consumes rupees. Yeah, you have to use up your rupees to actually use it in that game, whereas in this one it's just magic based. Which, I mean, you would expect, right? I mean, if you were playing like Ocarina of Time, you wouldn't expect to, use Din's fire at the cost of all of your rupees, because that would suck. And it sucks even more in Twilight Princess, because rupees are very valuable in that game. Like, you need rupees to buy a lot of stuff. There's a lot more, crap in that game that you need to buy. But then there's a lot of crap in this game that you have to buy, too. Right, okay, at least we took care of the battleships. Freaking nuisances. Right, can I get my treasure chart and make off with the goods without being attacked? We need to actually get the chart up to see where I am in comparison to where the location is. Okay, I'm miles away from it. Absolute mile away. It's like out around here somewhere. Yeah, I'm still quite far away. I think it's like here somewhere. Yeah, it's right in the middle here. Should be near enough, more or less over it. So let's try and see if we can get it. Ugh. You know what? These birds are really annoying. Freaking things, man. They're like seagulls in real life. You're sitting there trying to eat your food, and then one seagull comes along and thinks that you can try and take your food as if he owns you or something. Dude! Give me a chance to get on the boat and take my freaking bow and arrow out so I can nail you. No, I think he just gave up. Kinda got fed up, did you? Oh, he's about to come back for more. I can hear him squawking. It's like you're trying to do something, and I don't know, it's just... There you go, you got Pizza Hut. Wow, yay. Well, I already knew that was going to be Pizza Hut anyway, because I looked up some of these online, so... Yeah, doing some research. Right, I need to, where is this? Submarine at? It's like down here somewhere, wasn't it? Yeah, it's all the way down here. I don't know if I'm... Should I? Yeah, you know what? Just to speed up the process. I mean, having to sacrifice a few seconds to play the Wind's Requiem is a lot faster than trying to travel in a different direction against the wind, because that makes the whole travel a lot slower, which eats up more time in the long run. So, yeah, the last submarine we went into was complete bedlam, so hopefully this time it's not as chaotic. But we shall see. It is quite out of the way, so maybe, I mean, is that a sign of bad things to come? Like, they put it out of the way so that we didn't have to friggin' do this one straight away. I don't know. There's three outposts here for refills if you need to gather some stuff before delving into hell. Alright, so let's see what this submarine has to offer. I'm not gonna bother with the moblins on these rafts here, there's just no point. Considering I'm running out of time. Okay, well, moblins I can deal with. That I can deal with. So you can get out of here with your smelly ass. Why are there water pots here? They're not gonna give me anything. You got keys. So far, no wizards and no darknuts. Yeah, they're actually called darknuts, but darknuts and iron knuckles, like, how the hell are you supposed to tell the difference? Like, they literally look exactly the same. Darknuts in this game pretty much look like the same as they do in, you know, iron knuckles in Majora's Mask and Ocarina of Time, except in this game they look more cartoonish, obviously, and they've got a different appearance. But they look exactly the same. They wield a gigantic sword. Ooh, we got a spiky chest. So this is going to be something good. It could be a treasure chart. Most likely a treasure chart. I don't know. Or it could be a piece of heart. Who knows? And it's another piece of heart. Wow, okay. We got two pieces of heart in one video. Okay, pretty much straight. One after the other. Straight away. One after the other. Alright, let's get out of here. We don't need to be in here any longer. Even if there are more keys to kill. Maybe they're just endlessly respawning, but you don't need to kill them, obviously, to get the treasure chest to appear, and that's all we care about, so... Alright, so what I'm gonna do before we end off the video, because I'm gonna continue on in a different location... So we're gonna have to use the gales to warp us to a new location. And this is a location that is uncharted on the map. And it's this one right here. Because I don't know where this is going to take us. Probably Southern Fairy Island, I hope. Oh god, I hope. Because then we can get our magic meter extended. Because it's the only fairy fountain in the game that we haven't been to yet. So, I mean, it has to be. Yeah, it is. This is Southern Fairy Island. Alright, so I'm gonna end off the video here, and we'll continue on next time. And in the next episode of Let's Play Legend of Zelda Wind Waker, we shall have a look inside Southern Fairy Island to see what we can get. So until then, this is NDM saying thanks for watching, take it away to the next video, and goodbye.